I need a miracle. As we heard here, there are a lot of issues going on. A lot of challenges. Pain, suffering, broken relationship, disease, sickness. If anyone may be here, someone near you is there with a lot of issues, but he came anyway to church.
Hallelujah.
Today we want to see what is holding our miracle. What is holding our prayer? We pray every time. We ask God, I need this God. I want this God.
Hallelujah.
Really, giving can give you back a miracle. Because it's a principle of the kingdom. It's one of the principles of the kingdom. And the kingdom of heaven has many keys. Peter was given the keys of heaven, of the keys of the kingdom of God, keys with S at the end. To me, there are many, many keys to open the door of heaven for our healing, our blessing, our restoration, our breakthrough. There are many, many keys. The Bible says, give, and you shall be given. Good measure. Hallelujah. Good measure. I remember God told me about the miracle. I struggle a lot about money one day when I get here. And God told me, He said, oh, John, open up your Bible. I will show you. I said, open up the Bible in Isaiah 58. I know you pray a lot. I know you fast a lot. But you don't get what you want, what you need. Read that. And I start to read. When I was reading, it's like the Holy Spirit was close to me, telling me, explaining me word by word. Because I need a miracle. I was in need of money. God, how can I get money? I need the money, God. God started to teach me. It's about 8 years now ago. And I'm still keeping that principle. And God started to open up my mind. We don't have to read it because it's not my message. You find those people were the people of God who was praying, seeking the face of God. Want to know God? If you read as Isaiah 58, 1 up to 12, go home and sit down and ask the Holy Spirit to help you. You'll find all the answer of your issue are there. You want money? You'll find there. You want healing? You'll find there. You want your relationship to be mended, you will find there. I was astonished. Hallelujah. Those people were complaining to God. Why God? Why God? I don't know if you know the pain of an answering prayer. The prayer which doesn't bring an answer. I don't know if you know the pain. I know the pain myself. Sometimes you feel frustrated. You say, God, where you are? I don't see you, God. You have abandoned me, God. But God taught me, and was telling those people, he sent his servant Isaiah, said, tell them and tell them loudly. Don't speak quietly. Tell them loudly. Cry out and tell them so that they can understand. Yes, they pray and they fast. Today, the fasting day, we fast, we pray so that God can open the heaven. We can have a breakthrough. They were praying, those people. And God intervened and tell them, this is not the way. You need to fast and pray. Yes, I know. Yes, it's good to fast from food. It's good. It's good to do so. But it's not complete. Hallelujah. It's not complete. When I read, the Holy Spirit was explaining me word by word. It's not only that. God started to instruct Isaiah to tell the children of Israel, tell them, it's not only that. He started to give them instruction. Help people. Give to the poor. Feed the people. Clothe them. Not only pray, not only fasting, give to me, and you will see how things will change. The Bible said that in that point, even your healing will come quickly. God will accelerate your healing, your physical healing, your emotional healing. He will accelerate it. In the Bible, my eyes was open. Hallelujah. And the Bible said that then I will do something. I will bring the lights in front of you. I will remove all the darkness in front of you. Hallelujah. I will remove all the darkness. My righteousness will go before you. Whenever you go, I will make the connection with people. My glory will come behind you. And when you call, I will answer. When you cry, I will say, here I am. Hallelujah. Has given us all the secrets. But what's holding you to get those miracles? We need a miracle. And I need a miracle. I need more miracle. Recently, again, I faced a challenge of money. Because I have a ministry. You remember, you tried to collect some money here to help people in Burundi and Malawi. I help the orphans, the widows, the children who don't have the parents because of the war. They are suffering. They don't go to school again because there's no money to pay the fees. In Malawi, I lived there for more than 8 years in Malawi. It's the last country of this world in poverty. God put that country in my hand and said that if I leave this country and I go overseas, I will help some of the people in this country. Hallelujah. It was like a burden upon my heart. It's not my country. Hallelujah. But now, we've already built a school from kindergarten up to year 8. Hallelujah. And we say, let all the children, the refugee children that don't have the money, the parents, and all the surrounding local people, let them come and study and give them the chance to live. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, church. And recently I started, and I thank God for the church here, and some particular people here. They come to me, they say, God, John, we We want to help about the ministry. May God bless you abundantly. Hallelujah. Recently, I suffer again because they ask, no, we need to do that. We need to make the toilet. They are building. We need to make a toilet. We don't have a good toilet here. And I said, I didn't have money. Nothing ahead. I went to my room and I asked God, God, we need money. I don't want so that they can close that school. I need money, God. 2-3 days, I have some money to do my own things. I took that money. I said, God, I take that money for your kingdom. I give that money so that they can build whatever they want to build. And I remained empty without having anything. And I was needing money. But let's see. 3 days after, my wife, we were in a room about to sleep. And he said, no, I have a word to tell you. Sit down. I was fighting 2 days with my heart because I have some small amount of money I put aside to help my family. I was collecting and put the coins somewhere to help them. But I felt that no. I need to give you this money. I need to give you this money. I don't know why.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah, church.
I said, thank God. The next day, my son said, Dad, I don't feel comfortable. I feel that I can give you some money for the ministry, some money, and that we still needed money there.
Hallelujah.
What will attract our miracle? The kingdom of God is ready there to pour out miracle. God is today ready to pour out miracle to you in any area of your life. We need a miracle. The church needs a miracle. Miracle attract people. Miracle help. Miracle confirm the word of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, church. But what is holding our miracle? There is something. Faith. Faith. My brother, faith is a key. Faith. God needs your faith. God needs you to believe. Believing in God, it's not easy. I know it's not easy believing God. But you need to surrender and to accept whatever the word of God is telling us here. It's not easy. Faith is a risk. It accepts things with blind eyes. You don't know if really I'll get something there, but you accept it because God has said things. Remember when God told me, John, it's over for your secular work. You need to serve me. It's need faith. I didn't know ahead, 10 years ahead. I didn't see the future, what is there. I didn't know that. I was seeing the present here. What will be there, I think, in 10 years, God. But I surrender. I accept. I say, God, here I am. Do whatever you want. I'm ready for you. Is to be like a blind man. Is to accept everything. It's a risk. But risking in the hand of God. Hallelujah. It's risking in the hand of God. Faith. It's hindering a lot of things for us to see. Faith. to accept the things like it's already happened. Accept it like you see this chair already. You have that you're looking for the chair, and now you see the chair in your hand. Hallelujah. That is faith. We are sitting here in this room. No one is thinking that this roof can collapse. No one. Because we have faith that this roof is solid there. We are flying in an aeroplane from one country to another, reading our book in an airplane. Hallelujah. Even the plane is shaking, but you are reading quietly, knowing that you are going there and you reach there safely. Hallelujah. Prayer is like going in your kitchen and take the cup and open the water in your tap without to check that this water is dirty. You drink straight away. Hallelujah. This is prayer. This is faith. And one day, one of the churches in Africa, in that area, they were a dryness, no rain for 1 year. No rain. People start to suffer. And the church stood up. Hallelujah. The church, we are the solution of the nation. We need to intervene, hallelujah, for other people. They say, no, we need to pray. Join all the elders together and they start to pray. They pray, they finish. Next day, they come again. But in a corner there in a church, the pastor saw a lady who came with an umbrella. And there were a lot of sun there. It's not the customer to take the umbrella in the villages because of the sun and all. They are familiar with that. But she came with an umbrella. And the pastor asked her, why do you come with an umbrella? She said, no. We pray for the rain. And I believe that today it will rain. Hallelujah. Amen. And really, after the prayer, the sky became dark. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah, church. Faith. I know it's not easy things. It's very hard. But you need to surrender. You need to accept everything. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, church. You need to accept who you are and whom you believe in. You have something within you. You have a power within you, church. There is something you neglect within you. Hallelujah. Peter knew that. He knew that I have something to help this crippled man here in front of this beautiful temple. When that cripple was asking for help, Peter knew I have something within me. And he said that I don't have money. I don't have a silver or gold. But what I have, hallelujah. What I have. You have something. Hallelujah. You are all mature, you know. You have something. Peter said, in the name of what I have, in the name of what I have, is a confidence without any doubt. The Bible says that. when you pray, remove any kind of doubt within you. The Bible is clear. When you doubt, it says that do not expect to get something from God. Because you are limiting God. You see that God cannot do this. It's a big mountain. God can't do these things. And God is very frustrated. Say, how come you can humiliate me up to that level and I can't do anything? Hallelujah. You have Jesus within you. You have the word of God within you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, church. Peter said that in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Stand up. Hallelujah. Stand up. Brother, stand up where you are. Stand firm and know who you are. It's time now to switch from asking prayer to speaking prayer. Hallelujah. Asking prayer and speaking prayer, they are totally different. The Bible said that in Matthew 7:7, ask and you shall be given. Ask. You ask. You ask. And I'm waiting there. I'm waiting. I already asked. I'm waiting. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. But the speaking prayer is the faith God used to create these words. Hallelujah. He says something. He said the word. He released the word. God, our creator, who created you in his own image. We have the same image of God. We have the same character of God, understanding things. And because of that, you have a power to create. Hallelujah. Husband and wife, they're nothing. They make a human being. This is the power of creation. It's within you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, church. One day, Jesus Christ was about to be stoned with the Jews. They took the stone. They want to kill him. He said, no. Wait a moment. Why you want to kill me? And he was tapping them. He knows. Why you want to kill me? It's because I've done these good works. Jesus knew that it's not the reason. But he was trapping them so that they can reveal themselves. It's because of these good works I've done. They said, no. Not because of that. We want to kill you because you call yourself God. Hallelujah. And Jesus reminded them, you don't know the scripture? I was reading in my own language. What did Jesus say that? You don't know that I'm me who make you to be God with small g. Hallelujah. I make you to be God. Why you want to stone me because I'm saying that I'm a son of God? I make you to be God. Hallelujah. This is a revelation. Sometimes we don't want to meditate it and go deeper. Hallelujah. You are a small God. You can create things. Hallelujah. You can create. I can create by speaking the word. Hallelujah. servant of God I admire a lot. He's like my mentor. He went through a dry time, a very crisis, spiritual crisis in the church. People got sick. People died premature. People, no job. And everyone will come to him, Pastor, help us, pray for us. He prayed, nothing happened. And at the end, he went to seek the face of God. And God told him, he told him that, my son, the secret of miracle you are looking for, he said, read my word. Sleep overnight on my word. Believe my word. Apply my word. Hallelujah. And you see miracle happen. Hallelujah. The Bible says that if we abide in Jesus Christ and his word abide within us, there is no any condition, any barrier God can stop to give your miracle. He said that ask everything you want. Ask me everything you want. I know you are in Christ. But the word of God, check your heart. There is a word of God within. Hallelujah. There is a word of God there. We were given the treasure to unlock the heaven through the word of God. Hallelujah. Keep the word of God in your mind, in your heart. Sometimes, even if you cannot memorize, take your Bible. It's not a competition of memorizing the verse of the Bible. No. Take your Bible and read the promise regarding your issue. Read it every time, every day. You are creating something in the spiritual realm. Hallelujah. You are creating something in the spiritual realm. Speak. Say something. Don't keep quiet. Open your mouth and remove from your storage in your heart and speak over your situation. Hallelujah. Speak, because there is a power in your word. There is a power of creation. Hallelujah. I don't know if you know this group of women called AGLOW in America. It's a very big ministry. One day they decided to go to Russia to preach the word of God in the time of communism. It was very, very risky. But one lady among the group, God told them, you need to go there. And when you got there, you need to look at a good place and try to plant the word of God near that strategic place. Planting the word of God in a soul. Hallelujah. They went there. It's a true story. They went there and they stood in front of a big university where they used to teach about the atheism. They took the small piece of the treaty of the Bible. They make a small circle. No one was watching them. They dig the ground and they put the dot on top. And one of them pointing the finger on that university. And he said, yeah, university, we want you to change and to become a university of Bible study. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah, church. Amen. 2 years after, it changed to become a Bible study. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah, church. Amen. You remember, all of you, the wall of Bethlehem. the two Germany. One man called Dick, he was in America. God told him that go to prophesy to that wall so that that wall can collapse. He went up to Germany and he stood on that wall. He touched with his hand the wall and said, "You wall, collapse." Hallelujah! And he went back. 1 year after, Ronald Reagan went to Berlin. He stood close to that wall. When he saw that wall with all the cortege of people, the high people, he stood there. It was diffused all over the world. Ronald Reagan is pointing the finger on that wall, naming the name of Gorbachev, who was the general secretary of the Soviet Union. He said that, "Gorbachev, Gorbachev, 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 demolish this wall." Gorbachev was in Moscow. Hallelujah. 1 year after, they demolished that wall. Hallelujah. The power of speaking. Everything you see here can hear your voice. Hallelujah. It can hear your voice. He's waiting for you to open up your mouth with authority and power and faith. Hallelujah. God is looking for people who can stand on the gates between the family and the parents. Hallelujah. Between himself and his boss at work. Hallelujah. Between himself and the nation. Hallelujah. And speak the word. Speak the word. I have experienced these things, and this is why I'm talking to you. I'm giving you a good investment. Hallelujah. This is a great investment. I told you the other day, and I'm still telling you things, because a Christian, you need to have a testimony to build other people. I told you the way I went to Elizabeth Hill with my wife, and we stood there, it was 6 o'clock, and we prophesied on that land. Hallelujah. We say, "God, we leave everything for you. We accept to be humiliated because of you. And now we find ourselves in this new land. We need a land here, Father." Hallelujah. And we prophesy. We walk upon it. We prophesy. We prophesy. And after that, the miracle happened. I'm telling this story everywhere I go. And my people, and African people, I'm telling this, what God can do if you release the words. Hallelujah. Release the word of God. No matter, you may not memorize, take your Bible and open it and say that. Go in a room of your son. Maybe he's troublemaker. He's not there, he's at school. Get there and prophesy the good things about. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, church. Prophesy there. Touch your hand in his pillow and say, no. "God, I need my son to change." Hallelujah. "To have a good character. I speak these things in the authority of your word within me." Hallelujah. Hallelujah, church. Speak the word. Stick to it with faith. Don't waver. Don't waver. Stand firm. You'll see the outcome. Start repeating day by day, morning, evening, according to your issue. This investment I'll give to you. Let's move from the faith, the prayer of asking God, and start now to take authority. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
When Peter said, that's what I have. When you have something, you don't need to pray again. Hallelujah. You have something already. You need to use that, God. Use that now. Peter said, that's what I have. Jesus Christ himself used the authority within him. He never prayed. He never prayed publicly. Jesus, no. He comments. He was commenting. He commented the things. Hallelujah. You remember in the tomb of Lazarus? He stood up and said that, I know that you always hear me. Hallelujah. I always. He commented. You have a power to comment. You have a power to change the situation. But sometimes we believe God in our mouth, but in our heart we are very, very far. And this is the reason you keep frustrating. Decide. Ask God to open the river of faith within you. Ask God. If you doubt about God, look around you. Look around you. Do you believe that God has created all the things? When I'm flying in an airplane, many times I want to sit closer to the window to see the greatness of God, the marvelous of God, the immense firmament. You see the sky. Hallelujah. You see the cloud. You see the large ocean. And you ask, is it God who do these things? How powerful it is. Hallelujah. Our God is powerful. Jesus is powerful within you. He's above all names. Hallelujah. You can't compare. Your sickness, you cannot compare with Jesus. He raised even the dead people. He's looking for someone. He's looking for someone who can say one word. Can we read Isaiah 42, 22? Let's read. Accept this kind of restraint. Accept it within you. And try God. Try God. I believe he won't disappoint you. In any area of your life, he won't disappoint you. And God is looking for someone. Maybe this someone is you in your family. You have a lot of issues in your family. And God is looking for you to say a word. A word of healing in your family. There are not a problem in your family. But you as a Christian, you can stand there on a gate and proclaim the word. Hallelujah. Amen. Can you read for us, Joshua, if you can? 42, 22.
Have a mic.
Have a mic.
But this is the splendor and mountains. All of them trapped in pits, all hidden away in prison. They have become plunder with no one to rescue them.
Again?
They have plunder with no one to rescue them.
Hallelujah.
They have been made root with no one to say, send them back.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God is looking for a man. Only a man. Maybe could be you here today. Who can stand on a gate with authority and power and speak the word of healing for people who are struggling, who are in chain, in bondage. They are slaves of sin. No one can help them. And God is looking for someone to say, come back. Hallelujah. Only say, come back.
When you say come back, God will intervene himself. Hallelujah. He will intervene. Start to exercise. Because faith, you need to exercise it. No matter you fail, no problem. Keep exercising. Keep exercising. Speak the word. When I got that revelation of speaking the word, I don't ask anymore. I start to speak the word. Hallelujah. I'm speaking the word. I can see something. Hallelujah. And when you see something, it builds up your faith to continue. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, church. Speak the word. Speak the word. Let's read Mark 11, 22. Mark 11, 22. It's a well-known scripture. It's a well-known scripture.
Hallelujah. You get million.
everywhere in South Africa. Go there. They'll pray for you. Get 1 million in your account straight away. You don't know where the money came from. 1 million. You got it. You eat that money, and that money will eat you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You need to be careful. You need to be careful. You need to know how to apply the word of God. You need to understand the word of God. Read the word of God. If you don't understand, ask the pastor there to help you, to lead you. The problem, we don't ask. We jump to the Google man. Hallelujah. We jump to Google. Everyone to Google. It's good. Every time I went to buy the book in a bookstore, the Christian book, I will kneel down and ask God, can you connect me with someone? You have done something great in his life. Life experience. Someone who has spoke with him. Help me, God. Connect me with this man. And when I go to the library or to the bookshop, store, I can get that book. It can help me and it will help others. Hallelujah. Don't jump to any book. Don't jump to any website. Hallelujah. Brother, I'm glad to ask you. Start to exercise your faith. Start to say. The Bible said that. Let the weak say, I'm strong. Hallelujah. It doesn't say pray. Let the weak say, I'm strong. Let the poor say, I'm rich. Hallelujah. Let the brokenhearted say that, I'm healed. Start little by little. Little by little. God, I see myself anointed. I see the church, a big revival in my church. Say these things. Come here. Prophesy. You know, every time I preach here, I'd spend time there in the corner. Let me tell you the secret. And after I finish praying, take my word of God, I'll come. I'll pray over any seat you are sitting in. Hallelujah! Let me reveal me my secret. I'm asking God the power. The seat, the chair will be in disorder. I'll make the time here prophesying upon any chair. Hallelujah! I'll prophesy upon any chair you are sitting on. I say, God, you know this man. You know my sister. How he struggled. How she struggled. When she sat on this chair. Touch her.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You are coming to sit on a chair. I already poisoned the chair with the power of the God. Hallelujah. Every time I do that, I'll come to stand on that door. I'll put my hand on that door. I say, God, anyone who passes over this door, touch him with the message on Sunday. It's for the benefit of the kingdom. Hallelujah. For the benefit of the kingdom. It's my secret every time. I'll be here. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, church. We need to pray for others. Let's pray for others. Let's cry out for others. When you see someone suffering, when you see someone is crying, pray for them. Salvation is a package of everything. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I'm glad to give you this investment and to pour out my secret about prayer. Let's move now from asking prayer to speaking prayer. Hallelujah. Start to speak in your office, speak. Hallelujah. Speak. I told you the other day, God told us in Malawi, go and speak the word in front of the office of the administrator. There was a little bit, there was big famine in a refugee camp. Go and speak the word. In spiritual realm, there are some things doing there. When the guy touched the wall of Berlin and he went back in America, in a spiritual realm, something happened. God touched Ronald Reagan. He touched him. Hallelujah. And used him to proclaim again another prophecy. Prophecy. Do not wait to only the pastor or the prophet come overseas. No. Why? When the disciple were in a storm in the lake, a lot of storm, and they're scared a lot, and they cry out to Jesus. Jesus woke up and said, why? He rebuked the storm and the wind cooled down, and he came to them and said, how come with this kind of little faith? It's me. You should do that. Hallelujah. You should do that. That the reason to rebuke their little faith. You should do that. You can do that, brother. Mama, you can do that. You can change your situation with your word. Hallelujah.